Bonjour. Magazine Odem, a Wiro Kaza Bajgo, Indigenous Kaz, Wasak Sang Nandunji, Gayways and Zibi, Najundaba, Jaman Makgay Parwarmi and Dow. My English name is Wendy Phillips, and I'm of the Bald Eagle Clan and Ojibwe from Wasak Sang First Nation. And on behalf of the Indigenous peoples here, we would like to acknowledge and recognize the territory in which the University of Toronto operates on. For thousands of years, this has been the traditional territory of the Huron Wyandot, the Seneca, and most recently, the Mississaugas. At this time, today, this is a meeting place for many Indigenous peoples from across Turtle Island. And at this time, we would like to say how grateful we are that for us as an institution, that we are able to have this opportunity to work on this land. So, miigwech.
How do you do? My name is Cheryl Regier, for those of you I haven't met, and I have the great privilege of serving the University of Toronto as its Vice President and Provost. And I'm honored to welcome you here today to the installation of our new but already dear friend and colleague, Professor Wisdom Tettey, as the 11th Principal of the University of Toronto Scarborough. So, Chancellor Patton, President Gertler, Professor Satz-Kortzak, and members of the installation profession, and the academic procession, and members of Governing Council, the University of Toronto Scarborough Campus Council, presidents, vice presidents, principals, deans, UTSC faculty, staff, students, and everyone here, thank you so very much for joining us today at this incredible event here in the newly renovated Highland Hall. We are delighted to welcome our colleague here today. I'd also like to welcome our government representatives, Member of Parliament for Scarborough Rouge Park, Gary Andasaki, the Member of Provincial Parliament for Scarborough Guildwood, Mitzi Hunter, and Councillor for Ward 25, Scarborough Rouge Park, Jennifer McKelvey, and Councillor for Ward 21, Scarborough Centre, Michael Thompson. Our former UTSC principals, both Professors Joan Foley and Bruce Kidd, are here with us today. Thank you for being here. And of course, I want to extend a very warm welcome to Professor Tettey and his wonderful family, his wife Natasha Rodriguez, and their children Norvisi, Selassie, and McAfee. And before we proceed, I'd also like to take the opportunity to thank Dr. Marianne Chambers for serving as the Beadle today, a great friend of the university, and we're delighted that she's here with us again today. And you're going to have the opportunity to hear the Filippi Santa Jazz Combo featuring University of Toronto Scarborough staff members, Gray Gaffram and Phil Smith. And now I would like to invite President Gertler to bring greetings on behalf of the university.
Thank you, Professor Regera. Well, good morning, everyone. I, too, am really delighted to take part in this wonderful celebration this morning. On behalf of the entire university, let me extend congratulations to Professor Wisdom Tettey on his installation as the 11th principal of the University of Toronto Scarborough. We also extend best wishes to his family, as well as to all the students, faculty, staff, alumni, governors, friends, and partners of UTSC who are here to join us on this very happy occasion. Well, when an organization recruits a new leader, one hopes that that person is going to be able to hit the ground running. Well, from the moment his plane touched down at Pearson last summer, Wisdom Tettey has done just that. From day one, he has been deeply engaged with individuals and groups across the campus and in the neighborhoods and the city beyond. He has also established himself as a key leader in our tri-campus institution in his capacity as a vice president for the wider University of Toronto. He brings to the central leadership table a great wealth of experience and insight, and his important contributions have already been keenly appreciated by his peers. In everything he does, Professor Tettey demonstrates a marvelous combination of confidence and openness, clarity and sophistication, energy, commitment, and a great sense of humor. He wasted no time embarking upon a strategic planning process for UTSC, consulting widely across the community in an extensive and thorough process. He's profoundly committed to ensuring that everyone has an opportunity to contribute and be heard as part of his commitment to inclusive excellence. This is one of the hallmarks of great leadership, and it follows in the remarkable tradition of UTSC's brilliant past principals, including Professors Joan Foley and Bruce Kidd, who we are so happy to have joining us here today. Wisdom's leadership will further energize UTSC's outstanding executive team, and it will propel this amazingly vibrant academic community to new heights in the years to come. It's really so appropriate that we have gathered today here in Highland Hall. This building is a terrific metaphor for what we are celebrating. This new structure extends a legacy of design excellence that started with John Andrews' landmark building on the ravine. It adds to the cluster of state-of-the-art facilities that have sprung up at an incredible rate in recent years. And it is an emphatic statement of the ethos of this campus, UTSC's remarkable openness, its welcoming environment, its commitment to engagement with all who live and learn among and around us. And Professor Wisdom Tettey embodies that ethos so beautifully. His arrival as principal signals an exciting step forward in our shared academic mission. And Wisdom, we wish you continued success in this critically important leadership role. Thank you so much for joining us. I now ask Professor Wisdom Tettey to join me for the oath of office.
Please repeat after me. I, Wisdom Tettey, pledge to perform.
I, Wisdom Tettey, pledge to perform.
The duties of principal of the University of Toronto Scarborough.
The duties of principal of the University of Toronto Scarborough.
As prescribed by law and by the statutes of the university.
As prescribed by law and by the statutes of the university.
And I promise to defend the rights.
And I promise to defend the rights.
And to promote the welfare.
And to promote the welfare.
Of the University of Toronto Scarborough and the members thereof.
Of the University of Toronto Scarborough and members thereof.
In the name of the University of Toronto, I now install you, Wisdom Tettey, in the office of principal of University of Toronto Scarborough, and I invest you with the authority and charge you with the responsibility pertaining to that office. I now invite the Robers to come forward, Professor Maydian Andrade, Professor Alexi Chuyap, Ms. Tamar Musang, Mr. Kusei Hassan, Ms. Kemi Lamo, and Professor Paul Kingston to perform the official robing of the principal.
Thank you, Chancellor Patton, President Gertler, and Provost Regar for the invitation to be with you today. It's a real pleasure as we celebrate the installation of Professor Wisdom Tettey as principal. Today is one of those days that reminds me why I love living in the eastern edge of our great city and am so privileged to represent Scarborough Rouge Park at Toronto City Hall. I'm also delighted to be joined by my colleague, Councillor Thompson, today. Today, we gather to celebrate a gentleman who was born in Ghana, studied in the former Soviet Union, became an expert on the interrelationship between the media and politics of Africa, completed his PhD at Queen's, and is now rising to a leadership role at a keystone institution in the most diverse city in the world. If that's not a classic Scarborough success story, I don't know what is. Principal Tettey, I think your family is very proud of you today, and I'm glad to see them smiling in the front row. Scarborough is a diverse, welcoming hub and a great place to offer opportunity to those who want it. I look forward to watching you foster the next generation of leaders that will make Scarborough proud. Being here today is like coming home. More than 20 years ago, I was a student in the Environmental Science Co-op program. In fact, it was Vice Principal Goff who was part of the interview panel and accepted me. So maybe I owe all my success to his smart decision to let me study at this great institution. So Principal Tettey, you joined good company, and I look forward to collaborating with you, Andrew Arafuzman, and Brent Duguid, as well as the exceptional leadership team you have here to build new partnerships to renew Scarborough. On behalf of Mayor John Tory, City Councillor Michael Thompson, and the rest of City Council, congratulations on your success. We wish you all the best in your new role. Thank you.
Good morning. On behalf of the Chair of Governing Council, Claire Kennedy, who was unable to attend today, and my fellow governors, I'm honored to extend a warm welcome to Professor Wisdom Tettey on his installation as Principal of the University of Toronto Scarborough. By its nature, an installation is both a ceremony and a celebration. It is marked by a sense of history. At the same time, it represents a new beginning. As a ceremony, this event reflects the traditions of the Academy. It recalls the work of those who have gone before us and it reminds us of the responsibilities the principal will bear as the chief steward of this community of learning and discovery. As a celebration, today's gathering reflects our shared affection for this distinctive campus and our excitement about its future. It also renews our commitment to the vision of UTSC as a place of inclusion, collaboration, and innovation. Wisdom Tettey is the ideal choice to lead UTSC forward, but he is humble and will tell you that his role is that of a facilitator. That's spoken like a true leader. He is both a brilliant scholar and administrator and brings a unique array of experiences to the role that dovetails well with the campus's history of community engagement and partnerships. He is committed to fostering collaborations across the university, as he believes the stronger each of us can be as a campus, the stronger we will be overall as one university. Wisdom, on behalf of the Governing Council, I congratulate you on your installation, and I thank you for your great work in advancing our mission. My fellow governors and I wish you and the UTSC community every success in the years to come. Thank you all for sharing in today's proceedings and in the life and work of the University of Toronto Scarborough. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you, President Gertler, Provost Gregor, Chancellor Patton, Principal Tettey, for inviting me to be part of this important celebration and milestone in the University of Toronto Scarborough history. I'm delighted to be here back home, where my academic journey started many years ago. As a proud alumna and the former Executive Director for Development and Alumni Relations at UTSC, I want to formally welcome you to your new role as principal and on behalf of the 51,000 alumni around the world. When I was 17, I had the sheer excitement of getting my offer from the University of Toronto Scarborough. Although I applied to other universities and received a scholarship from another, not U of T, I wasn't that good, all I wanted to do was be at the number one school in Canada. Coming to the Scarborough campus was a life-changing experience for me. It was the first time I was away from home, I didn't know anyone, and while daunting, my time at this wonderful campus allowed me to grow and mature as an adult and recognize that I could be whatever I wanted to be and appreciate the power of education. I was active on student council, represented the University of Toronto Scarborough on the SAC, which is the Student Administrative Council, and I wrote for the student paper, The Underground. I even held a fundraiser to support Hurricane Gilbert, Jamaica's worst hurricane at the time, and I volunteered on numerous committees. During my time here, I developed my leadership skills, my confidence and ability to think critically and strategically. I learned how to thoughtfully debate a stance, or as I call it now, adjusting someone else's thinking. Over the years, Scarborough campus has grown and evolved. We have one of the most diverse student bodies and graduates, which enrich our experience every single day. We continue to attract outstanding faculty and staff who are truly committed to the student experience, research, and the future of higher education. We have amazing facilities like the Toronto Pan Am Sports Complex, an outstanding community facility, several new buildings that have been built in the last decade, including this one that we are in today. These edifices are not just buildings. They are spaces that welcome our community, build communities, and allow forums for experiential learning and innovative pedagogy. Diversity is our strength, is not our tagline. It is who we are and the DNA of this place. I had the privilege of meeting with Wisdom shortly after he was announced as new principal. I was impressed with his thoughtfulness, pragmatic approach, his long and wise view on the potential UTSC holds, the strengths and opportunities that exist, and how we are stronger together. He's a highly accomplished leader and academic with expertise in mass media, political communication, and civic engagement in Africa, and a fellow of the Ghana Academy of Arts and Sciences, an honor bestowed on a select few. While working with Wisdom, I got to see him in action. His warmth, genuine interest, and the people he meets, his ability to navigate challenging situations, his strong communication and negotiation skills, and of course, his wonderful sense of positivity and humor. He is incredibly supportive of faculty, students, and community, always prioritizing inclusion with a strong willingness to learn about new cultures and engage. Wisdom and I traveled last year on business to meet with our diaspora of alumni, university partners, and friends. His ability to share an exciting vision for our campus and to raise sights for the institution and his commitment to excellence was clear and resonated with everyone we met. As I mentioned, I had the opportunity to be the executive director here. Who would have thought that a 17-year-old young woman who dabbled in student politics and ran a few fundraising campaigns would come back to her alma mater and come full circle to run the campus's largest fundraising campaign? That is the testament to the power of our amazing alumni and what a great education does. It provides no limits to truly who you can be. Truly, truly boundless. I have been blessed to have overlapped my time at UTSC with Wisdom and the honor of working with him as my boss and colleague. We both value diversity and the occasional road less traveled and integrity in what we do. University of Toronto Scarborough is incredibly lucky to have you at the helm, and we are especially delighted to flourish under your wisdom. On behalf of the Alumni Association and all alumni graduates, I want to congratulate you and let you know we are here to support your vision in many ways and this wonderful place many of us called home as students. I look forward to supporting your success, working with you as you as a proud alumna and a colleague during your tenure. Warmest congratulations again, and on behalf of all of UTSC alumni, I want to welcome you to your new role.
You probably don't recognize me in these robes. I barely recognize myself. Bill Goff, Dean, just in case you didn't get that. Recently, in reviewing the academic literature on international student travel, the main factor for not participating in such travel was identified as not forming the intent to do so at an early age. So what does forming the intent mean? So after much pondering, I think this is just a fancy way of saying to dream. Our new principal, Wisdom Tettey, has had a lot of big dreams. So a bit of geographic comparison may illustrate this. Wisdom was born in Accra, Ghana, and now lives 8,670 kilometers from where he was born. I was born in Toronto, and I live 8.8 kilometers from where I was born. After finishing his undergraduate education in Accra, Wisdom fulfilled a big dream, came to Canada, to Queen's University in Kingston to do graduate work, and as you know, has pursued a highly successful academic career in Canada since. After earning undergraduate and master's degree in Ontario, I boldly decided to do my doctorate in Montreal. I left the province of Ontario. So, fulfilling another dream, Wisdom became a Canadian. And on that day, Canada became a better place. He got full marks on politeness and niceness, the two most important Canadian characteristics. However, I have to say he is a little weak on the concept of snow day. In the Canadian lexicon, this means unscheduled holiday. Not a day when the executive team meets anyway by conference call. In spite of our different geographies, we share in the most important of big Canadian dreams. These include reconciliation with the Indigenous peoples of Turtle Island, equity, diversity, and inclusion as expressions of excellence, and the transformative nature of education for everyone. Because of who he is, what he has accomplished, his abundant skills as a scholar and academic administrator, Wisdom will inspire dreams and the fulfillment of them. So on behalf of the UTSC faculty, I warmly welcome Professor Wisdom Tettey as our new principal.
What a wonderful morning. It's an honor for me to welcome Professor Wisdom Tettey on behalf of the staff of the University of Toronto Scarborough. First off, Wisdom, congratulations. It's been a short time that you've been here at UTSC, and you've already shown why the search committee made such an outstanding selection. When the search committee spoke to the various members of our community, they would have heard all of the excitement around the opportunities that are present at UTSC. They would have also heard about the key attributes that the next principal would need to demonstrate for us to achieve the goals that we've envisioned for this remarkable part of the University of Toronto. President Skirtler, Professor Reguerre, and members of the selection committee, thank you for demonstrating an in-depth understanding of what UTSC can become across all spectrums and of what it is that we do. And congratulations to your outstanding selection. UTSC is an exciting point in its future. We've made significant investments in our academic and scholarly activities. We've built new infrastructure to support our students, staff, and faculty to do their best work. And we've built meaningful engagements with our community. All three of these areas will continue to grow under your leadership, Wisdom. Wisdom, you first arrived at UTSC early in the academic year. Your top priority was to develop a new strategic plan for the campus. In developing that plan, your commitment to people on this campus was clear. As you developed a process which first sought to engage meaningfully with our academic leaders to anchor this plan, and then the broader engagement, including students, staff, faculty, to refine and develop the goals and activities. Your commitment to an inclusive, fully engaged process is reflective of the leadership values you embody. UTSC is in a unique position as we try to redefine the relationship that a university can have with its surrounding community. We have demonstrated that through engaged, reciprocal, and intentional interactions, our growth and evolution can have real, lasting intellectual, social, economic, and cultural impacts on the fabric of the city that surrounds us. Over the years, we've moved from an institution that people knew about but didn't interact much with to a leader in championing the people and the infrastructure of Scarborough and the Eastern GTA, knowing that as we evolve, we can improve the quality of life for the communities that are around us. In your short time here, Wisdom, you've taken the ideas that stand behind our anchor institutional role and begun to multiply the effects as you help us think through the future of the campus. Again, demonstrating how good a fit you are as principal and vice president of the University of Toronto Scarborough. On a more personal note, I'd like to thank your family, Natasha and the children, for making the leap of faith and relocating to our great community. I'm positive that you too will find this an incredibly exciting community to be part of. Professor Tettey, on behalf of the staff of the University of Toronto Scarborough, welcome to this great good place.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Scarborough Campus Students Union, I am honored to have the opportunity to speak to you today. Before I begin, I would like to acknowledge that we are on the traditional territory of the Treaty of the Dish with One Spoon, the Anishinaabe, of which the Mississauga of New Credit peoples are a part of, and the Haudenosaunee, the people of this tradition territory. It is important that we decolonize the spaces which we take up and recognize that violence that Indigenous people face to move forward to truth and reconciliation. Now, I'd like to say that it has been a great joy to have had the privilege to work with Professor Wisdom Tettey. I remember when I first started my term as president, I was both excited and a little nervous to hold regular meetings with the principal and addressing student concerns. However, upon introduction to Professor Tettey in an upper executive meeting, my nerves quickly slipped away in the presence of his kind smile and calm yet confident and inviting demeanor. Now, having worked with the principal for the past 5 months, myself and my fellow executives would agree that it is encouraging to experience his outgoing support for student initiatives. Professor Tettey has demonstrated on-the-ground involvement as he attended events such as SCSU and Hart House's Collaborative Human Library Project, as well as Positive Space's Rainbow Tie Gala. In fact, one of my favorite experiences with Professor Tettey to date was at the Rainbow Tie Gala, in which myself and Jimmy, who assisted with the robing ceremony, upon a request, he hesitantly entered into the photo booth with us. But then we were both surprised by not only taking photos with him, but he also entertained our request for a silly photo by throwing up a top-notch peace sign and a great smile. So moving back, though, to student advocacy, although we do not always agree, That happens from time to time in the Students' Union with the university. Professor Tettey has shown to hold an open mind and foster discussion in order to look for ways to continue the work. Nevertheless, whether it be stressing the importance of Scarborough's voice in the Tri-Campus Review, easing concerns surrounding the ominous free speech policy, supporting student consultation in the process of developing designated smoking areas on campus, or assisting in the installation of new barriers for the multi-faith prayer space in the Student Center, Professor Tettey has proven to be a valued ally. For this support, SUSU would like to say thank you. However, the work does not stop here, as outside threats make it more crucial than ever to prioritize students and student rights. We trust that Professor Tettey will continue to showcase this dedication to allyship by working with the Student Union to maintain and provide essential services to students at UTSC, especially those who are most marginalized students, who are often racialized students, queer students, disabled students, and all intersectional identities. In closing, the students of UTSC would like to warmly welcome you, Professor Wisdom Tettey, to our campus. We know that together we will continue to do great work, and we are eager to further unite our efforts in the strive for equity and innovative growth on our campus. Thank you.
Thank you, Provost Regier, Chancellor Patton, President Gatler, Chair Designate Sas Cossack, Provost Regier, Dr. Chambers, special guests, alumni, friends, faculty, staff, students, dear Wisdom, and Wisdom's family. It is indeed a great honor to be asked to introduce a dear friend and a colleague. But before I do that, I want to share some secrets with you. Not long ago, I asked Wisdom to buy me lunch. And he said, no, Nana. And he calls me Nana. It all depends on what you say when you introduce me. You know, as a faculty member, I tell my students most of the time, look, I know people in high places. And they will ask, how high? Now, normally I would look to the skies, but I'm so thankful that even the skies will allow me to look down and look around. We have Wisdom. Thank you very much, University of Toronto. In the African adage, there's a saying that it's not what one is called that is important, it's what you respond to. Now, I think Wisdom epitomizes both. It's only Wisdom who can be a vice president and a principal of a great institution. He has taken up the role and the call for leadership. And I think that Wisdom is going to help him very much to success. I've known Wisdom for over 30 years, and I can assure you that please take your money to the bank. Allow me to say a few words of a travelogue of excellence for my dear friend. Professor Wisdom Tettey is a political scientist and a leading scholar in African media, politics, and transnational citizenship. He was born in Accra, Ghana, and was educated at the University of Ghana, where he had his BA, first degree honors, first class in political science and Russian. And he also completed a postgraduate diploma in communication studies. As an undergraduate student, Professor Tettey studied for a year at the Pushkin Institute of Russian Language in Moscow at the height of the political transition in the Soviet Union. He came to Canada as an international student and obtained his master's in political science at the University of British Columbia and subsequently a doctorate in political science at Queen's University. It was at Queen's University that Professor Tettey started his academic career. And from there, he got an appointment to the University of Calgary, where he spent 13 years as a professor of communication studies and development studies. During this period, he's also served in various administrative roles and was appointed interim dean for the period 2008 to 2010. He returned to his alma mater, University of British Columbia, in 2011 to take up the position of dean of the Faculty of Creative and Critical Studies at the Okanagan campus. In 2015, he was named dean of the Ivan K. Barber School of Arts and Sciences, a position that he held until July 2018, when he became Vice President, University of Toronto, and Principal of University of Toronto Scarborough. Professor Tettey has published extensively on Africa as an interdisciplinary scholar, including on the political economy of globalization and information technology, media, politics, and civic engagement, brain drain and higher education, diaspora networks and politics, and representation and citizenship rights. He has also served as a consultant on a number of agencies, including the World Bank, the United Nations Development Program, the African Capacity Building Foundation, the Partnership for Higher Education in Africa, the International Association of Universities, Freedom House, and the Third World Academy. He has held visiting appointments at the University of Ghana, the University of KwaZulu-Natal in South Africa, and at the Ghana Center for Democratic Development. In recognition of his scholarly accomplishments, he was elected Fellow of the Ghana Academy of Arts and Sciences in 2013. Throughout all these years, Professor Tettey has been staunchly devoted to the cause of social justice, equity, and enhancing the student experience. As dean, Professor Tettey led efforts to integrate equity, diversity, and inclusion to faculty and institutional policies and practices. He has always sought for a balanced representation of diverse groups in his leadership teams, and he has worked to promote indigenization as a focal point of the academic mission. He has stood up for staff who were not respected or were bullied by faculty. He has also mentored and supported racialized and minority faculty as well as staff at other institutions to navigate the structural and systemic impediments and unfair practices. Professor Tettey has been a holistic understanding scholar of the student experience, having served not only as a scholar, teacher, and academic administrator, but also as a student teacher during his undergraduate and graduate student years, as a resident Don Life, and as a resident Life coordinator. His strong commitment to inclusive excellence and human rights is reflected in his scholarly and administrative work, including in his role as the anti-racism coordinator in the Human Rights Office at Queen's University. Professor Tettey has always wanted to be an intellectual. For a while, he taught about law, but he settled for academia generally. Very early, and this is because he grew up surrounded by fascinating discussions and debates that stimulated his mind, so we know where his name, Wisdom, comes from. On top of all this, he plays soccer, volleyball, basketball, and tennis. Finally, Professor Tettey is married to Natasha Rodriguez, and they have three children, Makufi, Novisi, and Selassie. To all members of the audience, please join me in welcoming a very distinguished scholar who our university has gained, Vice President and Principal of UTSC, Professor Wisdom Tettey.
Chancellor Patton, President Gertler, Provost Regeer, Professor Sass Kotsak, members of the installation and academic procession, elected representatives, distinguished guests, colleagues, students, faculty, staff, alumni, neighbors, friends, and supporters. Good morning, and thank you for gracing this occasion with your presence. It is a great honor to have you all here this morning. I want to thank our Indigenous hosts for allowing us to share this land and for working with us to develop its potentials together. Let me use this occasion to also acknowledge my 10 predecessors, two of whom are here today, Professors Joan Foley and Bruce Kidd. Their vision and leadership nurtured and elevated UTSC to the reputable institution that it is today, and we're all very grateful for their laudable accomplishments. To my dearly departed parents and my siblings, I owe you an immense debt of gratitude for your constant and invaluable support and love over the years. My sincere thanks also go to my extended family and friends around the world for your kindness and guidance. While some of you are not physically present, I know you're here in spirit. My ineffable thanks go to my spouse and partner, Natasha, and to my children, Makafui, Novisi, Selassie. Tash, Kaf, Sisi, Tobi, thank you for helping to renew, to sustain, and to enrich me every day with your love, encouragement, sacrifices, and support. Bebelet and Chief, I promise to continue working hard to pass your course on how to recognize the difference between work and vacation. Dear members of our UTSC community, friends, and supporters, let me share with you the origins of my strong affinity to the values of this campus, my deep desire to further the mission of this institution, and my passion for keeping the commitment of UTSC to our host and partner communities. The story of my journey here is anchored in a framework of inclusive excellence, which I hope will define the very character of this campus, be amply demonstrated in our daily routines, be embraced and proudly acknowledged by all, and be sustained beyond my term as principal. In a lot of ways, my journey to this position is a familiar one to many of you in this audience. You know what it's like to grow up without much, or at least of others who do. You know what it's like to aspire to something and to work hard towards it. You know what it's like to be a traveler or immigrant to a new and familiar environment. You've been enriched by the diverse ideas, peoples, and communities that you've encountered on your life's journey, and can vouch for the excellence that is born of inclusivity and opportunities for all. My journey resembles yours, although the specifics may differ. I grew up in Ghana in a low-income, pluricultural neighborhood of the national capital, where diversity, marginalization, and community converged. Those beginnings and the privilege of subsequent experiences around the world have helped me to see excellence in the midst of deprivation, to see good emerge when communities are motivated by common purpose, mutual commitment to that purpose, and belief in one another to accomplish it. I know firsthand the impact of teachers and mentors who care, as did my elementary school teacher who facilitated my enrollment in special prep classes for the National Secondary School Entrance Examinations when my mother could not afford it. I embody what it means for communities to come together to create access to opportunities and to invest in people in ways that enable excellence to be recognized, nurtured, and supported. These encounters with and lessons from the realities of diversity, community, altruism, and the generosity of others were mediated through my family experience, particularly through my mother, who has had a tremendous impact in shaping the values and principles that inform me as a person, a citizen, and as a servant leader. She never had a formal education, but she instilled in my siblings and me an understanding of the value of education as a game changer, as a path to self-actualization and to mobility that enriches the pool of contributors to the common good. She is the source of my ingrained belief in and unbridled commitment to equality and equity. She inculcated in us the value of selfless duty, the concept of service as a source of innate fulfillment, the indisputable essence of integrity as the bedrock of leadership and service. the importance of using our privileges to create opportunities for others, the capacity of respect, caring, and support for others, irrespective of their station in life, to validate our common humanity and to enrich us all. This is the background that made me find a close affinity with this campus and this university, who share these values, with this community, which echoes my own journey in a lot of ways. It is this commonality of values, purpose, and experiences that attracted me to this campus, this institution, and this community several months ago. It is what informs my commitment to inclusive excellence, which is at the heart of my vision for UTSC, a vision that is distilled into four imperatives and related commitments. These imperatives and commitments, which constitute two sides of the same coin, are one, to advance a culture of leadership that is bold, empathetic, shared, transparent, inclusive, and transformational, thereby enabling our collective aspirations to be realized. Two, to promote and support an inclusive, healthy learning and working environment. Three, to strengthen, grow, and sustain local and global networks and partnerships that advance our mission. And four, to augment University of Toronto's global standing through scholarly prominence and exceptional learning in unique areas of established and emerging strength. These complementary and mutually reinforcing imperatives and commitments are a sine qua non for our success. They are also strongly aligned with President Gettler's three priorities of leveraging our location for mutual benefit of our city and our institution, strengthening our international partnerships, and reimagining undergraduate education in transformative ways. Let me address each of the imperatives and commitments in turn, starting with leadership. Bold, empathetic, shared, transformational, and inclusive leadership is critical to the success of our mission of inclusive excellence. I, however, do not see leadership as the exclusive preserve of a few. We all have to assume leadership of our shared values and of our commitment to a collective mission, irrespective of our position or the scope of our role within the institution. In fact, many great transformations have their origins in leadership exhibited by those who do not occupy officially designated leadership roles. We'll therefore promote and support a culture of shared leadership, where leadership is seen as an honor, a privilege, and an opportunity to serve and to make a positive difference, where inclusive, empathetic, and accountable leadership is intentionally fostered, where creative and innovative leaders are empowered to advance our collective mission and to uphold our values. We all have leadership roles to play in the everyday life of UTSC, no matter our location within or our relationship to the institution. Whether as a student who challenges a peer writing racist graffiti on campus or denigrating online posts, as a staff member who thoughtfully and appropriately responds in a snowstorm to the needs of our diverse community of individuals with different abilities, or as a faculty member who enriches our curriculum with a variety of intellectual perspectives and knowledge systems, or as someone who makes access to a UTSC education possible for talented students who may otherwise not be able to avail themselves of that opportunity. It is this kind of shared leadership that would enable us to realize the second imperative of and commitment of promoting and strengthening an inclusive and healthy learning and working environment. Genuine embrace of different experiences, backgrounds, perspectives, and identities is what will sustain a vibrant intellectual community like ours, where we strive every day to inspire limitless ingenuity, address the pressing issues of our day, and generate solutions that are boundless in their impact. Indeed, the University of Toronto's standing among an exclusive group of institutions in the world owes a lot to the community of diverse, talented individuals from around the world who work and study here. We take tremendous pride in our diversity at UTSC, arguably the most diverse community to be found anywhere. But in order to attain and sustain our goal of inclusive excellence, it is imperative that we go beyond diversity and create an environment where every potential and current member of our UTSC family feels a genuine sense of belonging and is given an equitable opportunity to make their best contribution to our academic mission. Consequently, we'll build on initiatives that address systemic and structural biases that impede access to opportunities for participation in the excellent learning and scholarly activities that happen here, that embrace and promote the enriching contributions that come from the diverse backgrounds, ways of knowing, ideas, and perspectives, and experiences represented in our community. Initiatives that solidify our commitment to physical and mental health for students, faculty, and staff. And initiatives that intimately embed indigenization into our academic pursuits and the daily experiences of our community. I also committed to initiatives that significantly erode, if not eliminate, the capacity of anyone or group to find a safe haven for bigotry, ableism, racism, homophobia, transphobia, and other efforts that seek to divide us, discriminate against any individual or community, and rob us of the meaningful contributions a diverse and inclusive campus makes to our mission. We'll all work together to normalize well-being and inclusion as a core foundational characteristic of our campus by weaving them seamlessly into the tapestry of all that we do as an institution. I challenge all of us to start by thinking of and relating to those who are marginalized or are constrained by existing structures and practices as equity-deserving groups and not equity-seeking groups. A concept which, while well-intentioned, perpetuates a perception of these groups as interlopers. Those on the margins of our community who feel or are made to feel that they do not belong deserve equity as a right. They should not be given the burden of seeking it, and they should not be made to feel that they get it as a privilege from the generosity of those who have the power to give it, and hence the power to take it back. As a critically minded, knowledge-creating institution and a learning organization, we can lead the way by changing the rhetoric, the narrative, the language, and the unintended negative connotations with the use of empowering, inclusive language. Now to the third imperative and commitment of building and sustaining excellent local and global networks and partnerships that make a positive, transformative impact locally, regionally, nationally, and globally. As an institution committed to community building, we'll leverage our areas of established and emerging strength to lead and or to partner with others in our region and further afield to help bring the benefits of the excellent teaching, research, and learning that takes place here to others beyond our institutional boundaries. We are very proud of our numerous partnerships with our local communities, individuals, alumni, civic organizations, businesses, industry, different levels of government, and our sister anchor institutions in various sectors, some of which are represented here today. We'll do this. I'm committed to extending our reach, to embrace, and to bring into the fold of UTSC supporters many more collaborators who believe in our mission and reflect our commitment to reciprocity, knowledge co-creation, and global citizenship. Through common purpose with those who share our values and support our students and our scholarly and learning endeavors, we'll be cementing our place as a lead anchor for the socioeconomic development of our region and ipso facto making a meaningful impact on our world at home and around the globe. Investing in the preceding imperatives and commitments will put us on an unshakable trajectory to the fourth, which is augmenting U of T's global standing through prominence in research, creative activity, and exceptional learning. I will strongly support our excellent community of students, faculty, and staff to position UTSC as an attractive, accessible, research-intensive campus with global reputation in unique areas of academic programming and cutting-edge scholarship, both disciplinary and interdisciplinary. We'll do this in part by fostering collaborative learning and scholarship that generate the critical mass of quality and activity necessary to bring us global prominence in areas of established and emerging strength. We'll also vertically integrate scholarship and curriculum to ensure strategic program development that aligns growth of graduate and undergraduate programs with our areas of strength and supports our efforts to expand our community of postdoctoral fellows and other highly qualified personnel. We'll continue to pursue transformative learning initiatives at both the undergraduate and graduate levels that cultivate citizens and leaders with a social conscience an intercultural and global outlook, and other competences needed to be versatile and adaptable to the uncertain and disruptive dynamics of the contemporary global political economy. My vision, by way of these four imperatives and commitments, is to set UTSC apart as a prominent hub of inclusive knowledge production, creativity, innovation, and community development that augments U of T's standing as a global powerhouse of scholarly and teaching excellence and sustains our institution's global eminence as one extraordinary university with three exceptional campuses. I'm excited about the strategic planning process that is underway to help us entrench these imperatives and commitments into our identity as a campus, as we leap forward towards the kind of prominence we aspire to. Based on the passion and enthusiasm with which our leadership team, students, faculty, and staff have embraced and taken ownership of the process, I have no doubt that those aspirations will be realized. I'm confident that I can count on all of you to rally around these imperatives and commitments with the passion and conviction necessary to bring our shared vision of inclusive excellence to fruition. I close with a Kiswahili word imani, meaning faith or belief, and a Zulu proverb, umuntu ugumuntu ngabantu, variously translated as a person is a person because of other persons, or it takes a village or a community. Let us believe in what we can accomplish together. Be there for one another as a community. Pool our diverse talents, abilities, ideas, and experiences for common purpose in the spirit of inclusion. And our success and prominence will know no bounds. I'm humbled by the trust that you've placed in me as principal of this great campus and as vice president of this remarkable university. I'm grateful for the opportunity and the privilege to serve. I pledge to justify your trust. Thank you all for your contributions to UTSC's accomplishments, for your confidence in its unbridled potential to soar even higher, for doing your part to inspire inclusive excellence that benefits all, and for the honor of your presence today. Thank you very much.
Wisdom, thank you for coming and sharing your vision, your insights, your passion with us today. Thank you for your commitment to leading this great campus and being a part of this great institution. We are absolutely delighted that you have joined us, and we are so excited to see what is going to be happening in the years to come. Thank you, thank you. I also wanted to take a moment to just thank Natasha, who I met for the first time in the Okanagan Valley. And as Andrew said, we are delighted that you have taken this leap of faith and come along and brought your family. I want to thank Norvizi and Selassie for starting a new school and just sitting here today. I know that's been hard. So thank you very much for being here. And we look forward to all the wonderful things about to happen here out in University of Toronto Scarborough. And as always, we end these events with the last word going to our wonderful Chancellor, Rose Patton.
Thank you, Professor Regaire, President Gertler, and good morning, everyone. It is such an honor for all of us to be here, I know, but especially I feel it's such a great honor for me to be here in today's proceedings. And I'm so pleased to offer as Chancellor one final congratulations to Professor Tettey on his installation. In a way, you could say that President Tettey and I started our roles together because just after my election to office, he arrived soon thereafter. So we can begin by thinking that we are part of the entrance class of 2018. And that places me in very good company, so a very good start. Anytime I've been at UTSC, beginning with a visit with President Tettey and his team in the early fall, I've been repeatedly impressed by his energy, his warmth, and his optimism. Those qualities are so perfect for this wonderful campus, with its rich culture of academic leadership and community engagement. We heard so many descriptions of President Tettey, And we heard in his remarks how he is seized by excellence and leadership. We heard some examples of how he sees the path to this excellence and leadership through collaboration, through diversity, through inclusion, through partnerships, through the creativity to innovate, through the courage to transform. It'll be hard for us to wait to watch his leadership unfold and see the impact that it will have. But the optimism is something that has really stood out for me, not just as it relates to President Tettey and what I see on this campus, but what I see throughout the entire university. The U of T just radiates optimism. It can be spotted everywhere, from its strong values of diversity and inclusion to its drive to make our world more just and prosperous, and to its incredible contributions to knowledge and innovation in every field. Wisdom, I know you're already making a tremendous contribution to this positive culture. And as I say, we'll be watching your impact. I'm sure it will be a vital and impactful factor in U of T's continuing unique strength as a tri-campus institution. On behalf of the entire university, I wish you every success. And as chancellor, I look forward to celebrating many more milestones with you and the UTSC community in the years to come. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for this big and happy day. And this brings us to the conclusion of today's ceremony, but our celebration continues. And we invite you to stay for a reception immediately after the recessional, just behind the curtains. And now, I would ask you to please rise as you are able for the singing of the national anthem. Thank you.
Our land, glorious and free.